some of the decks we're going to play later today probably aren't so good, but I think this Redlings deck is great. Well, that sounds a little awkward. Coin kind of being medium. It's got a Trike and Underworld Crusader in it, though. One of the things to keep track of is that... One of the things to keep track of is that I've got Lazgar's Vengeance in my main deck now, so we do double Ruby, and we actually just Ruby Shard there. Curve 2-2 into 3-3 Rage Speed. No turn 1 play, no turn 2 play is good for us. I guess I could go... dupe. Doesn't seem awful. Yeah, I'm gonna go. Go like this. So the upside to this is if my opponent has a 3-drop here, we could still attack him with the Graven Geist. Yeah, and they have an Ardent Crusader here, so I'm not super surprised by this. So I go ahead and play this. And play Ruby. So I think I'm going to play Mortartrike Driver here. Oh, no, maybe that was wrong. I'm going to hit this. Maybe I should have played the Wicked Webspawn, actually. So I can go ahead and smash with everything. If I smash with these, so I'm basically like trading the Mortartrike Driver for 1, 2, 3 points of damage. That doesn't seem particularly profitable. So I'm just gonna hit like this. We activated our champion power, so we get to put 2 Dreadlings into the crypt. So that means we could actually scrounge this into a 6-6 next turn, since Graven Geist gives all of our troops scrounge to get +2/+2, which is nice. Graven Geist is a pretty reasonably powerful card, just like self-enabling, which is nice. If he doesn't have another play here, he's in a lot of trouble. Deal. No blocks. We are off to the races, sir. Okay, yeah, I was going to say, better have something here. Taking the Mortartrike Driver, too. Okay, deal. So, when we scrounge this, it's going to... Turn this into a 3-1, because I had 2 troops leave my crypts. This is 6. Yeah, it's just really solid hit here. Just crack them for 11. Seems good. Good, solid, aggressive start. Another Decree of Banishing. That's kind of annoying. I guess the good news is we still have, like, our flyer here. Got that going for us. Next, we get a hit for 3. Probably has to leave this back, right? You don't just want to trade. Trading 5 for 2. Okay. All right. Well, let's go. Webspawn. This, and then hit you for 5 down to 7. Seems pretty reasonable for us. I feel like they were a little bit too aggressive with this. They need to be a little bit more controlling in this matchup. So our draws, they just explode when they go off. You could Wicked into Wicked. Get a 4-4 and 2 extra Dreadlings. Yeah, maybe. Like, if I Wicked before I Crusader there. That's fair. I feel like he just doesn't have enough going on that it doesn't really matter. Like, he's just, like, dead to this Cremate either way here, right? He's gonna, like, gonna go block, and then take 5, and then I kill him with Cremate. Shard here, also Deece. This is just dead on board. Yep. Would love the 4th Lazgar's Vengeance for this matchup. I don't think we mind 1 Gemborn Prowler. What do I actually want to cut, though? What are the cuts? Most of these cards seem pretty good. I don't really want to cut anything. Interim the Blamsmith, maybe. Then bring in Gemborn. Rustbucket's insane. Oh, you know what? Deathseeker's kind of medium, right? Like, it's just like... Yeah, I'm actually going to cut... I'm going to cut some Deathseekers and put the Valor Gem back in this guy. Deathseeker just doesn't line up well against their other idiots. Swift Strike of this actually seems better than Valor, I think. Let's give this a go. Do I want another Gemborn and cut another Deathseeker? A Crusader's kind of annoying. Yeah, it's probably fine. Drawing two Underworlds, drawing two Gemborns when they don't have any socketed troops will feel real bad. No bite. There you go. Yeah, it seems really good. We got a Lazgar in the opener. We draw a second Ruby Source in our first three draws here. It seems just very good. Let's go 1, 2, hopefully 3. Yeah, look at that. Everything is coming up Millhouse, as we say. Warturn General, sure. So this is a 1-1 for 2, that whenever they play an Ardent Troop, they get a Valor, and then it gets +1/+1 for each Valorous Troop they control. I'm gonna lead on Dust here. Grab a Ruby. Go ahead and attack with this guy, start triggering our Lazgars here. I'm gonna play Crimson Slayer, because he's more likely to be able to attack in next turn. Pretty good chance he just, like, plays a 3-4 or 4-4 out here, and we get Stonewalled, but... The 2-3 is a little bit better at blocking too than the other 2-2. Okay, so they played that and they get a Valor. So they could Valor this and offer the trade here. They're Valoring that one. And again, this is a reason to have played the 2-3 out. Please attack me with a 3-3. Please attack me with a 3-3. God bless. This gives me free reign to attack with this next turn, which lets me attack with this too. Jeez, that's good for us. So now we just like play Mortartrike Driver out, beep beep. And then we hit this for 2, which then triggers Lazgar's Vengeance 5 times and gives us Scrounge for next turn. So like next turn I'm gonna get to Scrounge my Wicked Webspawn, which will give this plus power and give this plus power, and then cast Lazgar's Vengeance. God, this deck's curves are so good. Like, how is this? And he's only attacked once, so even if he attacks 2 more times here, he's worse still not in Lazgar's Vengeance range out of him. This is a messed up hex card. Just like 4 damage to your opponent and every troop they control. Yeah, so I'm trying to spread out my streams a little bit. I need to figure out. I'm working with Ollie and Matt and Andrew, the people on the team that I've been working on, to try and figure out a schedule that's a little bit more spread out. All right, so they're just dead here basically, right? I play this for whatever, and then they're probably gonna concede when I play this. They don't even have to count, but you know, we can think about it. Kill your board, kill you. Play this, and it has Scrounge 2 because of Graven Geist, which makes this a 5 and makes that a 3. I guess he's technically not just dead. And I suppose if he has a Lazgar's Vengeance of his own in his hand, he's attacked 3 times. If he plays a shard, he can Lazgar me back. Fair game. I should have waited to play that up because of that. Nope, just dead. Alright, GG's opponent. Up to 76 on the constructed ladder. Down to 16 on the limited ladder. I would like to double queue this season. Just like, have qualified on both halves of the ladder, but we'll see. I don't know that I'm gonna work that hard in constructed. I'm just working to... 2 drafts a day keeps the bad limited rank record away. A Ghostly Flow. Waiting to queue. Heidi ho, the Cheerio, waiting to queue. So this hand, like, looks okay at a glance. Like, opponents playing Yodels are probably an aggressive deck. We've got, like, one drop into two drop. This is probably fine. Four shards with no coin is a little much. And I can see this reasonably being a mulligan because we're not going 1-2-3 guaranteed. Still Agamage, sure. Yeah, we deserve that. I deserve every second of that flood. Probably should have pitched this back. No Lazgar's Vengeance in the opener. Just like there's a lot of sixes that look better than this seven. Yeah, pull. You know, can't win all of them, or even most of them, really. All right, let's draw some troops here. Man, that's an aggressive start out of my opponent. The, yay, ding, Underworld Crusader. You don't mind if I do. The Crackling Magmas in our board are looking good. Looking promising, Crackling Magmas. Every time, this is a 1-1 for 1. And every time it readies, it deals 2 damage to your opponent, so. This card's interesting in Yodel. It could enable the Orc Shard, so I can see why it might be playable, but the fact that you can never champ power its Diligence seems real loose. Sweet, that's good for us. Asgard's Blood Sworn. Yep, that's a 3-3. That's maybe it. Yeah, so about those Crackling Magmas. Another resource. Rough. I think I'm playing this, and I think we're actually sitting on defense here. I'm going to hit these so I can fill the crypt for some scrounge fodder. So that way, like, next turn, if we draw a troop, we can go Graven Geist into, like, scrounge the troop for +2/+2 and, like, start pressuring with the Graven Geist. There's, like, one card left in his hand. He might, like, sack the baby Yeti so he can attack in and trade here, and I think I'm fine with that. Let's just draw two cards. It gives us a chance to, draw some extra troops, just like that. Yep. So now we're gonna play a resource here, and then I'm gonna play Graven Geist, and then I'm gonna play this Underworld Crusader, which now has Scrounge, thanks to Graven Geist. This is now a 6-6, which makes some Dreadlings. Is this worth attacking with? We're taking like 3 on the backswing, but yeah, okay, he's just conceding. All right, sure. I agree. I feel like I'm winning this game. A mythic. All right, up to 70. This is one of the reasons why people ask me what's the best way to 64 all the time. Get in early. Get into Cosmic early and start playing your matches early. Because you can see here, every match when I'm getting, I'm moving up like 5 to 10 spots even. And early in the rankings, everyone's MMR or whatever the record, the score that they use, is really close to each other. So just getting on and playing and being consistent and playing, you know, 2 to 3 matches a day, even 1 to 2 matches a day a lot of the time, you could just spread out instead of trying to, you know, grind 80 matches the last week of the season. You could spread those 80 matches out over, you know, the course of an entire month, and it's not really a big deal. Gosh, this hand is a little loosey-goosey because we don't have a ruby, but if we hit ruby in our first 2 draw steps here, this hand's insane. We get to go Deathseeker into Lackey into Mortartrike, hit our champion power for 3 Dreadlings. Like, looks like we're playing a mirror here. Have to cremate on 1, sure. Lazgar's Vengeance, also good against most Ivan Slagpot decks. Rats! We're just not being professional enough today. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and hit Lackey on 2 still, I think, here. This deck's very good. There were 2 different people. No one on our team ended up playing this deck in the CCS, but there were 2 different people that 6-2'd with it. Opponent's hand doesn't appear to be doing a whole lot. Ruby Shard. That's unfortunate. Yep, crack you for 3. Ticking. Lazgar's Vengeance still ticks out, even if we don't have thresholds to cast it, so that we got that going for us. Play this out. Pass the turn. I'm putting it up here. I'm putting it there for you. Cycle the coin, sure. I don't know that you could really keep hands like what my opponent kept this game. Like, he just didn't, he was able to kill our Deathseeker, but like he didn't do anything on the second turn. Maybe he just has like a bunch of Crusaders in his hand along with Lazgar's Vengeance, in which case I guess I could see that being okay. Okay, beep beep, move a Mortartrike Driver. No blocks, I'm gonna take my 3 here. Come on, running shards here. Running ruby shards. Alrighty, can you feel it, fam? Can you feel the burn? Mortartrike Driver could feel the burn. Alright, let's sack one of these Dreadlings to revert this back to a 4-4. Let's get in there. Get in there for however much damage this is. Look at that Lazgar's Vengeance. This deck is so good at triggering Lazgar's Vengeance, it's insane. It's just unreal. And now, if he wants to pressure us with this, he's going to need to play 2 troops out. Otherwise, this Rustbucket Distractor is going to be able to make 1 not block. We had a Ruby Threshold next turn. This game's going to be over. Over! Yep, there's your Crusader. Scale of 1 to dead. Where do you think you're at, opponent? Oh, is he attacking? How much are you attacking with? Just these, right? It's got to be just these. I feel like he's going to go... Whoa! You're dead on board, right? 5, 6, 7. Oh, they have a Deathseeker to play out, sure. That's fair. I guess you're like making me have it. Scrounge this nerd. This card is so good. That can't block. Yeah, got him. But shouldn't you have attacked and then reverted, or is Emperor Lackey sorcery speed? Yeah, you are correct. You are 110% correct that get an extra Lazgar's Vengeance trigger if I attack first. Not close. Good call. Extra Lazgar's Vengeance in. What am I cutting? Crimson Slayer? Crimson Slayer is like my go-to trim, basically. I guess Deathseeker doesn't line up very well against a lot of their stuff. Although curving is nice. I guess I'm on the draw and want to curve like boop boop a lot of the time. Actually, I'm gonna trim a Mortartrike Driver as good as it was that game. Cause it's a little slow on the draw. Although I guess they're always attacking, so like it's gonna get to attack and trigger. Yeah, maybe that's fine. Okay, so opponent mulliganed. We're up a game, so we're gonna keep this hand that's a little bit loose because this hand is just like in. I like keeping hands with this, especially on the draw. Just like the payoff is so huge if we hit a blood shard in our first two draws. Even our first three. Like if we just get to go like Rustbucket into Crusader into Crusader. Alright, there's the Lackey. So ideally we hit blood here so that way we can play the Wicked Webspawn. Am I supposed to play this out? Yeah, I think I am. I feel like we just can't do anything. We can't just pass. And like, this is, you know, this is, I don't think missing on a hand like this makes it objectively wrong to keep. And like, our average six, our average six being reasonably high quality would be a reason to keep this hand. But I feel like the payoff on this was too huge to pass up. How's Geist been? It was a card I was unsure of. It's actually useless. Geist is good. It, like, it's another Scrouge Enabler for you. It's an evasive threat. The evasiveness comes up a lot. Like, there's a lot of matchups in this format where, like, the ground just gums up hard. So that card gives you a way to kind of punch through over the top. All right, blood? Blood? Alrighty. We'll just go ahead and move on to the next one here. Go ahead and save. You know. Took a risk, did not get rewarded. I want the Mortartrike Driver, right? Yeah, cut the Crimson Slayer. Beep, beep. This card's so good. Coffee's for closers, and Mortartrike Driver, he gets himself some coffee. And it's great. Just very good. And remember, since we have Lazgar's Vengeance, we only need single blood threshold, so... Single blood, double ruby means we're going to be able to play all of our cards, and three resources means we can play every card in our deck, sans Lazgar's Vengeance that hasn't been triggered yet. So we get to play Lackey on two, Crusader on three, probably hit the Champ Power on three so we can Rust Bucket on four. You want to use your Champ Power fairly aggressively in this deck because your Champ Power is your primary means of fueling your Scrounge. So like, anytime you're getting two Dreadlings out of your Champ Power, it's just like, yep, A-okay, swing on in. What would be our best draw? Our best draw next turn would be, we'd love to get a Lazgar here. Rustbucket Distractor, that's fine. I'm gonna offer this trade here. I think I'm okay with that with the context of my hand. We're gonna hit him for five, even if they do take the trade. I can attack with both of these because if they want to trade Lackeys, I can sack a Dreadling to make that happen. This lets me draw cards as well, which is nice. Yep, so we'll go ahead and boom and trade. Also gets us another card in our crypt for Scrounge Fodder. I'll sacrifice my Dreadling that's gonna die anyways to revert this back to a 4-4. So next turn we could actually go Wicked Webspawn into Scrounge Rustbucket Distractor to make some Dreadlings. Whenever we scrounge here, Wicked Webspawn makes two Dreadlings for us. So, you know, good dealio. There's a Wicked Webspawn of his own here. That's gonna 10 out of 10 not be able to block next turn. Cletus 08 with the brand new regular subscription. I appreciate it. Welcome. Alright, let's play this out. And then again, just wanna... We got plenty of Scrounge Fodder, and we wanna add pressure to the table, so it's like 10 out of 10 Rust Bucket Distractoring this Wicked Web Spawn. This card... It's funny. So, like, Andrew, Mike Klutz, one of our... My teammates, he put this original... The original shell for this deck together. But then... You know, we had some small additions. Like, one of the cards his first iterations was, he had one Rust Bucket Distractor in the deck, and we just kept playing games, and I was like, you know, I feel like there should be four of this card. It's just like, it gives you such insane, like, when your deck never wants to stop attacking and they're often on defense because of it, like, this card's nuts. It's nuts, and this coin here makes our opponent lose two life. How insane is that? Yeah, whichever works better for you, mate. It's all the same to me. I only put the Patreon page up because I had people asking for that, and who am I to deny people their ability to give me money on their platform of choice? Just took me a little bit of time to set it up. So whichever is easiest for you. Okay, there's a Rust Bucket Distractor of their own. Probably gonna distract my web spawn here. I'm gonna make my Lackey not be able to block. Sure. So what we're trying to dodge a Lazgar's Vengeance here, basically. If he has a Lazgar, if he had a Lazgar in his opener, we could actually lose this game. I feel like that's the one way we lose this game. I mean, interesting to see if he attacks with this or not. If he attacks with this, I almost feel like I should block because it kind of screams Lazgars to me. Okay, sweet. No attack with that, unless I've miscounted his attack triggers. I think that means he doesn't have Lazgars right now. Because this can't block, so the only reason not to attack with it is because you don't want to trade it here. What a blowout. They brought in the Crackling Magma. I guess I should have played around that. I don't think that card's particularly good in this matchup. Because it misses Graven Geist, but I could be wrong. I'm going to start by cycling this, see if we get a Crusader. That explains why they made this not block. Usually just buying a bunch of deck and jumping into games, or should I games against other people and do story mode? Yeah, just, honestly, it depends on what you're going to do and what you're going to have fun doing, right? Because, like, games are something you should play to have fun, so... If you think you'd enjoy playing the single player mode, play the single player mode. I spent about an hour, personally, I spent like an hour and a half, 2 hours playing the single player mode just to like get a feel for the mechanics of Hex. And then once I decided that like the game design was something I was enjoying, then I went ahead and invested in a constructed deck and just started playing a bunch of constructed. Oh, to remove the camp block. Yeah, you're correct. That's fine. We have a... Alright, man, I'm gonna lose this game too because of we blocked that Dreadling and we got crackling magma. Tough beats. It's weird. Play better, lose less matches. Now this is the Lazgar's Vengeance, or are these just camp blocks so they should attack? Damn it. Had the Vengeance the whole time too. Alright. So if I would have not blocked with my thing, he'd have taken 4 extra points of damage last turn, and he'd be at 5. And then this turn, I could possibly kill him. Yeah, just flooded out a little bit here at the end. I made one bad block because I didn't correctly deduce that they'd have Crackling Magma in their deck, but just a few too many resources at the end there. Not enough coins. Too many regular shards. But yeah, if you enjoy playing constructed, just like pick up a cheap deck and dive on in. If you enjoy playing limited, drafts. Drafts and Evo are good ways to just like pick up some platinum and just start playing those. Yeah, I made a bad block. I didn't bring in the Crackling Magmas because I didn't think they killed enough things, so I wasn't playing around it. But I ended up having 3 out of my 4 cards at the end were shards in my hand, so like the fact that I didn't play around Crackling Magma really ended up not mattering ultimately. Like I could have gotten in like 4 more points of damage, but like you had the Lazgar's Vengeance anyways to clean up. Like having the Lazgar's Vengeance in your opener is definitely like the trump card in the Ruby Mirrors. Yeah, this limited format is really good. I enjoyed triple 5 drafts as well, so maybe I've been the minority, but I know people commonly, the commonplace was that it wasn't triple five wasn't as exciting, but it's just like not a proactive card is the problem with it. This hand's a little medium. It kind of wants a 2-drop other than Rustbucket Distractor, because generally you don't want to play this out as a 2-drop. Like we will. No, I mean the minority of people who thought set 5 triple 5 draft was great. I know everyone, most people think triple 665 is good. So, some kind of Blood Wild deck. Could be Horrors of War. Why the Crypt Dust? We've got enough. Is a Horrors of War deck? Has Bride of the Damned. That's interesting. We have more than enough troops, or we have more than enough necrotics to enable Cryptos. It's just like an extra dual shard for us. Add some consistency to the resource base. Crimson Slayer is actually an excellent draw because, like I said, I really don't want to play Rustbucket Distractor on 3. Or on 2, apologies. Yeah, basically Sin Pure, like, it's reasonable when it gets going, but like, I feel like Mortartrike Driver steals more games than this does, and that's why I'm up to 2 trikes at this point, and only 1 Cabalist. Man, that's... I can't decide if that's good or bad. Let's draw a Ruby Shard here, or a well. Ding. Alright, so we do that, and then... we just slam this Crusader, and then... it's unfortunate that this only makes one thing, but I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to do that still. It, like, gets Lazgar's Vengeance triggering too, so, like, next turn I can Vengeance to clean things up. I don't quite know what my opponent has going on, because they've got Horrors of War in their deck, but they've got a lot of random troops too. Maybe they're a Horrors Crusader deck? Yeah, this guy, Crimson Slayer. There's a reason we're down to 2 of him. I guess I could see switching this, like going to 2 Pyresmoke and playing a second Crimson Slayer. He is less than ideal in these cheap shot matchups though, which is just like not irrelevant. Cheap shot's a very well positioned removal spell right now. Like I say, good morning, afternoon, and good night to everyone wherever you're out in the world. Thanks for choosing to spend part of your Tuesday here with us. Hope everyone's having a good day. My name is Jeff Hoagland, and I am a TCG player / content producer, and welcome to my Twitch channel. That's really rough. So his cottontail bricked earlier, but this hit. But it bricked, but it gave them enough things to scrounge. Oh, we're killing that instead of this. Deal. Okay, that's it's like not the worst for us. Shard would be okay here. Alright, Wicked Webspawn. Huh. Yeah, let's go nuts. So we do this, and then I can double Cremate. Huh. What if I double cremate him and then I get to Lazgar's Vengeance post combat? Yeah, let's do that. Because he might not block the Crusader. Sorry, I was reading. So I started to do the spiel and then I started looking at my other screen. I should pay more attention. Look at this is like just the best Lazgar's Vengeance deck. Why did I scrounge again? Because I'm going to have infinite guys? Okay, I didn't really need to scrounge. Oh, I scrounged because I wanted to get guys. Right. It is in fact early. I actually don't drink coffee. Please eat a Dreadling. Please eat a Dreadling. Please eat a Dreadling. Rats. Am I playing Lazgar's Vengeance here? Now, I'm going to hold the Lazgar's Vengeance. It lets him put 3 more Tarantula Eggs in my deck, but I feel like having this as a surprise next turn is going to be worthwhile. Potential to clear out more blockers here, like that. That annoying card. Is he dead here? He's almost dead, right? We just, like... hit the Lazgar's Vengeance, puts you to 6. Oh, and then he's actually dead, right? If he doesn't have a removal spell here, he's dead. Does this trigger Scrounge twice? I feel like it does. It says Scrounge twice. Did it make 4 with this? Yeah, it does. Yeah, it does. Alright. God bless. That's like a combo. You have a hero fall for this that you wanted to spend on something else, but now you're dead to Dreadlings. I mean, like, the resource cost that it has on it is not negligible, right, Kletz? Ooh, when you have to cheap shot the Dreadling. Right, we knew he had the cheap shot too, right? So. All right, so playing the Emperor's Lackey out here means we'll be able to keep a threat through a Horrors of War for two here. Probably keep the web spawn. We can re-scrounge this and make two more Dreadlegs, which will both be lethal. I mean, we have the fourth in the reserves for when they're really good, right? That's annoying, but they're probably still dead here. Ben! 82081 with the brand new Twitch Prime subscription. Thank you for that. I really appreciate it. Man, what a beating.
Has the paw of you as you can in the board, in the bin too?
Man, are we gonna lose this game? God. What a tilt. It's like, has the Rotten Rancor? Let's draw a Cremate. Come on. Come on, Cremate. It's a Ruby Shard. We're just playing this and passing. We have the Ticking Time Bomb of six things in our deck. Could I... Oh, could I have taken a better line at any point this game? Whenever your opponent wins a game at one life and you're playing an aggressive deck, I always feel like there was probably a point where you're just like, you mismanaged slightly and could have pushed an extra point of damage. Usually I'm pretty good. Oh, this gets rage and comes back. That's fair. I would say that's random, but it's conscripted, so that makes sense. The reason I didn't swing with the Deathseeker is because it ultimately doesn't matter. You are technically correct in that it is optimal to swing with the Deathseeker. The way we win this game doesn't involve the Deathseeker coming back to our hand and getting plus one point of power. Like, we're losing this game regardless of what this card does. We're winning this game by peeling a Lazgar's Vengeance and triggering Assault on it, or by peeling a Cremate and killing them, or by drawing a Coins, actually. I forgot we have coins in our deck too. Man, we actually have a lot of outs, but I don't think any of them involve this Deathseeker. Oh, the charges from this. Oh, that's cute. Yeah, I didn't think about that. Yeah, you're right. I still don't think it matters. He's got a lot of blockers, but yeah, sure. I'll buy that for $1. It wouldn't have killed a blocker off last turn, but we would have gotten a charge towards our champion power, which could be relevant here. Come on. Where's my change maker? That's unfortunate. What if I play this? Play this, make something not block. Hit my champ power for two. So, like, say this can't block. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blockers. And I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 attackers. All right. I don't think I die in the backswing here. I die in the backswing to removal spell, right? So he goes chump, chump, eat this. If I attack with this, one more thing dies, but I'm dead to removal on the backswing. Yeah, I don't think I want to be dead to removal on the backswing here. I think I'd rather give myself another chance to draw a coin, a Lazgar's, or a Cremate. We missed one charge this game, not attacking with the Deathseeker, so I guess that could actually end up mattering. because if we draw a shard next turn, we could hit a champ power that we don't have now because I missed getting a charge because of the Cabalist. Things to think about. Small plays. Is he scrounging again next turn? Why would you double block the Crusader? We're not dead on board at least. We got that going for us. This making two battle hoppers has been so relevant for him. Wow, that's great for us. Come on, coins. Yep, if we draw a resource next turn, we're down to charge and could have killed him.
Alright.
Mistakes were made, ladies and gentlemen. Mistakes were made. Cheap shot. He's going out on my terms. Get out of here. Oh, jeez. So this double conscripts because of this card? That's annoying. Ugh. He just hit one of our 10 outs. The old double conscript, the same thing. That's cute. You gotta attack me with this, right? I guess he could just leave this back on defense, because, like, the tarantula eggs will get me at some point. Yeah, I feel like attacking with this has gotta be right. Right, so that dies. That means having an extra charge would not have been lethal here. Yeah. None of that has mattered, Dark Wonders. None of that has mattered. The only thing that's relevant is the charge, possibly. Am I dead on board? Go block, block, block. Yeah, I'm dead on board if he attacks, he's to attack with the Fentio. Yep. Oh! Oh, holy shit, that's a huge misplay. That's a huge misplay. I could have sacked the Crusader to get two more draws. Yeah, good line, Shadow Zord. Good line. Alright, we're dead now. But yeah, could have sacked I die on that swing there. But ultimately I end up getting more draws, right? I didn't see rabbits or crusaders out of him, so like I'm not 100% sure what our opponent's doing exactly. I'm not sure I'm a Deathseeker and bring in a Lazgar's Vengeance. Not doing a whole lot here. I feel like you board pretty minimally with this deck. We only get one more draw out of sacking the Crusader because his guy in the air kills us one turn sooner. But we do see plus one card. So it's plus one card, it's not plus two. Yes, this. And that's why this deck is sweet, right? Like it's an aggressive deck that has a lot of really punishing draws for your opponents. Yeah, exactly. It's the type of deck that is really sweet to play because like there's a lot of minimizing and maximizing and sequencing decisions to make. It feels a lot like if you played Hex TCG during set four, the Yodel Burn deck that was popular then. The power level on this is probably a little bit higher than that, actually, but, like, a lot of the sequencing and the bob and weave and the fact that, like, it's an aggressive deck that has a lot of choices and play to it is huge. It really ended up in a good spot. The Emperor's Lackey and the Rustbucket Distractor. You guys should have seen the first drafts of this deck. Wasn't quite as pretty, was it, Klutz? This was the final piece of the puzzle, just like moving these from the board to the main. The turn you had the Webspawn and you cheap shotted a Singular Drillier to save a life. I'm pretty sure you had two resources that could have scrowed the Rush Bucket. Nope. Nope, go back and check the video. I only had one. We knew he had the cheap shot. I had to play the web spawn that turn, and we only had three resources. No, did I play the web spawn that turn? Okay, now I'm not so sure. Maybe I'm thinking of a different Zuko. I'm pretty sure we didn't have the resources to do that, but I'm willing to accept that I don't remember and could be wrong. So check the archive. But you're right, we knew he had the cheap shot, so if I could have scrounged the rust bucket, we should have, but I feel like I either didn't have resources or didn't have things in my crypt. One of those two. Because I remember thinking we can't kill him through a removal spell here. I remember that thought running through my head, but it could have been an incorrect thought. How cheap is your shot, opponent? That's not a great draw. It's kind of awkward too because we're heavy on resources right now, but we also don't have double ruby for Lazgars. Elwins, you know you can buy cards for platinum, right? Or for actual dollars? They let you. You can trade your other cards, in fact. Instead of playing an Evo, you could just put that platinum towards buying a Geist. Well, at least that's a resource that gives us another ruby. I really don't want to make just one thing. Crack you for three, play this other Geist out. Hi, buddy. Need to show me something real quick? I'll be right back. My toddler wants to show me something. Nope, we're not going upstairs right now, Declan. We're hanging out down here. Crusader with reach. That's annoying. Alright, so we really want to hit a, Rustbucket Distractor here. Another shard. That's basically it. Yeah, I'm just going to hit this to make two Dreadlings and push a point of damage. Morning Tracks. This way, if we hit Rust Bucket next turn, we can use it. So, little flooded. We've had 7 resources and 11 cards here. One of which was a coins, at least. So, another upside. This is an aggressive deck that gets to play 4 coins in it to mitigate flooding a little bit. Yeah, I get a little variance in their part. Ooh, Zentos Hunger. That's hot. Bride of the Damned. That's scary. Also lethal, which is kind of annoying. Take 4. No attacks. I guess I don't want to trade this for this. Deal, I guess. That's a Rust Bucket Distractor. Okay, so what am I doing here? This is actually kind of interesting. So, like, I can, if I put another troop in my crypt, I can scrounge this twice. Because I can scrounge one for target troop can't block and then scrounge it for +2/+2. I think I like doing that, actually. If I sack the Graven Geist, this Emperor Lackey, that seems okay. This is not great against cheap shot, I guess. This makes 4, so like it fuels our scrounge hard too. It makes this into a 4 power guy, so that can't block. think I'm okay trading Lackey for Bride here. Yeah, and he's down to three here. Seems good. Yeah, oh yeah, he's nowhere near five blood. He's got one. The classic Bride of the Damned in my double wild deck. And I've got 1, 2, 3 different Underworld troops here, and I've got a shard in my hand, so I'm gonna get to hit this again next turn, not to mention they're dead in the sky. Howdy, Ian. What you got? Oh, that lets them kill things. That's unfortunate. Still dead to shard champion power, I think, right? No, but not anymore. That's unfortunate. Yep. So, give me a piece of action. Give me a piece of action. Give me a piece of action. Well, this is going to force my opponent to trade with these guys, so I think we still do it. Hit this, put them to one, put them in the same position they were in last game, where coins, cremates, Lazgar's vengeance, just like everything is lethal. Yep, so obligated to trade there, they go to one. Yep, go. Just like infinite draws there that kill them. Still have some number of draws to kill them out of our deck. Got 3 coins and 4 cremates. Another Crusader. It makes the clock real fast. Yeah, I should probably bring in a Gemborn next game. I didn't see these in the first game. Don't lie to me. Can't pay the 8. Ha! Ha! I knew we were going to flood a little bit more, so we're now up to 9 shards and 14 cards. Yeah, I'm like, this just like shows the power of this deck, right? Like, we've drawn 9, our aggro deck has drawn 5 spells this game, and our opponent's at 1, and we have 12 outs to kill them. Like, how insane is that? Yep, game short. That's fine. Probably messed up that first game. We'd gotten one more draw, and we can't draw an extra card at the end to find out what the sequencing, what it would have been. So like, if we'd have been punished or not. You got Dad's box! You little monster, say hi, Internet, my name is Declan.
Oh.
Yeah, sounds fine. Crimson Slayer on 2, Underworld Crusader on 3, smash. It only has one Underworld type towards our champion power, but that's fine. Need more Winter Moon. Get out of here, Allie. Stream yourself. We're gonna play decks more interesting than that here. And by that, I mean smashy, smashy. Maybe I should stop keeping 4 shard hands even when they have good curves. Ah, my opponent told us to be lucky! I hope I'm lucky, opponent! I would love to be lucky! Lucky, lucky, lucky! Ooh, another mirror. This deck's definitely getting popular. It's very good. It's a very good laddering deck too, right? Because, like, it's got really strong aggressive curves. Did you know that Redlings wins the mirror 100% of the time? Why is Prince Zakah good in the same deck as Extinction? What am I missing there? I feel like I'm not drawing a parallel. What am I missing? Ollie, all of your decks are miserable to play against and nobody wants to play with you. At least that's what I heard from a credible source. Ooh, that's a lot of nerds.
Hey, look at that. Daddy drew a spell.
Alright. I'm just gonna smash with this. I feel like I'm okay trading this for his guy and draw two cards. Yeah, look at those spells. God bless. Oh, so they're still playing one of the older builds as the Shard Prism in it. Ooh, that means they probably don't have Lazgar's Vengeance in the main. They should have them in the board, but our build that had Deathseeker. Yeah! Yep, that's a good, pretty good payoff you got there. Crack me for infinite. Scale of 1 to dead, where am I at here? Pretty dead. Take 7. I guess I'm only going down to 14 here. This has Rage, though. Cremate is a very good draw. Let's play this. Let's scrounge this. Let's do this. Let's play this Underworld Crusader out and smash. Yep. I guess maybe I should have hit my champ power for just one so I could scrounge Rustbucket Distractor next turn. Yeah, that's probably correct. Tron Dragons! With the 6-3 stun. Let's get a good 6 months from Magic to Pokemon and finally to Hex. Enjoying all of the games and the content assistance we provide. Keep it up. Thanks. I appreciate the support, Tron. Thanks for sticking around through all of the new adventures. Oh, it didn't have the death cry. Okay. Oh, he gave it the +2/+2. That's what he did. Got it. Oh, jeez. Where am I at here? So this is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. No blocks. Oh, geez, and you just got all the triggers from that. Yep, we're dead. We needed to hit Lazgar's Vengeance there so we could attack with three guys and then Lazgar's Vengeance them. Turns out, always the out in the aggro mirror, the Lazgar's Vengeance. Yep, I'm going to bring in that, and I'm going to cut Crimson Slayer's fine. I don't know what I want to board out. Probably a Deathseeker, just in case they like bring in Crackling Magma. It's probably a fine hedge. Hey, that is not your chapstick. That is your mother's chapstick. You're a year and a half old. You don't need chapstick. Our opponent told us to be lucky, and then we weren't. I feel so cheated. Don't tell me to be lucky when I'm not going to be lucky. Oh, opponent Mulligan. Maybe we are lucky. I get to lead on our coins here. Pass the turn. Ow, don't pull my beard, child. Ugh! Ugh! Who's the tiniest monster daddy has? Turn one Geist. Pretty good. Pretty good. We've got a turn 2/3 though. Alright, hitting Crypt Dust is actually pretty good here, because this can only give us our first threshold of a type, so this can give us our first ruby, and then the well gives us our second. Having Lazgar's in the opener being on the play is pretty good, usually, in the aggressive mirror. The old triple scrounge. So I'm gonna play the Webspawn, which gives us a second Underworld type here in play. And then I'm going to go ahead and activate my Chant Power, which lets us crack in for 4 here. Next turn, we can scrounge a Rustbucket Distractor, which will make 2 Dreadlings with this, and then we can attack for 4, and then hit this Lazgar's Vengeance, so that seems good. Please attack me for 4. Please attack me for 4. Please attack me for 4. God bless. Free block. Scrounges, which triggers this. Is he just dead, actually? So if I play this and I scrounge this, that'll make 2 more Dreadlings, which will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then this will go to 8, which is 14. So I can put him to 2. And clear his board. Yeah, that's probably fine. And like, there's no way we can get Lazgar's next turn, right? We've only been attacked 1, 2, 3. I guess there's a world where we could get Lazgar's next turn, so this is too aggressive in a world where we get Lazgar's next turn. I think Cosmic Dragons is my favorite set 4 constructed deck, like 10 out of 10. Not particularly close. Alright, that is not a shard that lets you cast Lazgar's Vengeance. So, dead. Got him. Got him. Dead and gone, you could say. And again, I feel like I just want to hit submit. Maybe 1 Crackling Magma is fine. Hey, let's do 1 Magma the draw. Let's do it. You want this? No. You want to come in? No. What does this hand do? This hand has a Lazgar's Vengeance in the opener and a turn 2 play into a turn 3 Crusader. Probably fine. Let's just like hit a set. Let's hit a ruby threshold in our first 3 draws, first 4 draws really. Doesn't have a 1 drop. It's good for us. Oh, jeez! Look at the huge mistake I've made. This hand's like a speculative keep on the draw, but like 10 out of 10 glanced at the hand and thought those coins were a crypt dust. You know, eh. The payoff on this hand, if we run off sub ruby, is good, but, yep. You could say mistakes were made. We couldn't draw blood the other time we kept a hand like this. I might have still kept this hand. Yep. Now, let's hit a ruby so I can kill this, please. Go this, kill this. Ding, fries are done. Alright, so... yeah. Cremate. This nerd. Play Crimson Slayer. And again, you want to activate your champion power fairly aggressively in this deck because you want to get Scrounge Fodder in the Crypt. This also lets us trigger our Lazgar's Vengeance here in the event that we're a true professional and draw an additional ruby. So, really no point in blocking the other taking 5 either way. I guess they could see if I miss it. So next turn, we can Wicked Webspawn into Scrounge Cremate, which will trigger this and this, which is kind of sweet. Cosmic Dragons without the direct damage chip is much, just not, yeah. The damage gem is what made that deck possible. That being said, Immortal is a better place without the direct damage gem. Just for reference, I am fully, firmly in the camp that Immortal is better off without the direct damage gem. In case there was anyone wondering. Did I just, like, jam this Crusader down his throat? I feel like I might just jam the Crusader down his throat. Silly 3-3 Blamsmith making a brick wall for my dorks. Alright, beep beep. Yeah, I'm just gonna play this. And then, am I offering this trade? I feel like I'm offering this trade. Holy shit. What a- Oh wait, this doesn't work how you want it to work. Never mind. You're cool. Resolves. Alright, was about to be a little tilted, then I remembered that we could do that. Man, I'm glad I didn't click past that, because then I'd have been more tilted that we'd have missed the sweet sack my Crusader to my Lackey to play around your Gemborn. I don't know what you want more of, buddy. Can you show me? Yeah, you can. Okay, after Dad finishes this game, we'll go get you whatever you want, okay? Whatever you want, you know, within reason of a toddler. Yep, Crusader of his own, sure. Attack me. Please attack me. Please attack me. Please attack me! No! You're supposed to attack me. Okay. Ruby Threshold, Ruby Threshold, Ruby Threshold, Ruby Threshold. Another Lazgar's Vengeance. Alright, beep beep, what are we doing? I think we're just doing this, and then, like, hoping you not get Lazgar's back. Yeah. And a bunch of troops in our crypt here, so would like to hit another Scrounge card or a Ruby Source next turn. And we would like for our opponent not to have a Lazgar's Vengeance that they can play this turn. Machinations. They have two different types, so yep, that's dead. That's fine. Now do you want to attack me? I mean, what's the worst that could happen if you attack me, opponent? I mean, like, really? What could possibly go wrong? No, don't cremate my guys. I wanted that one. He doesn't have a Scrounge payoff here, at least, which is nice for us. Sure, yeah, can't block. Deal. Alright. Please attack me. Please attack me. Attack me and let me draw a Ruby Shard. Very well. It worked out pretty well for the fact that we didn't have, this is a free block here, right? I guess he could have another Cremate. Ruby. Alright, that's also fine. Yeah, so I'm gonna do this. I'm actually just supposed to, like, take this and point it upstairs, right? Because, like, killing this doesn't... Oh, I guess killing this lets this get through. Yeah, that's fine. And I'm scrounging this, even though we don't need the resources, because it makes these larger for reference. Oh, we know his last card's Gemborn Prowler, too, right? Yeah. Alright. Beep beep. God, how insanely dead is he if we hit another Ruby this game? Just like scale of one to slaughtered. Just like completely gone, blown out the window. Wow, that's a good draw. Holy crap. So now he gets to play a 5-5? What a beating. And have a 3-1. Alright, come on. Come on. Come on.
Come on, Declan, channel your energy. Daddy needs a ruby shard. Daddy needs a ruby shard. Ruby! I believe!
That's not what we wanted. Alright, so...
Play my web spawn past the turn.
Skip. Alright, we have a scrounge payoff now at least, which is nice. Another scrounge payoff.
Man, I'm gonna trade Crusaders here because I would really like to draw Ruby Threshold. Declan, I need you to channel your energy better here, buddy. I need you to channel. Oh, this has Scrounge too? Oh, baby, it's about to be a triple. Oh, baby. Yeah, sure, man. You do you. You get 4/4s. You know what dies to 4/4s? You know what 4/4s die to? Lazgar's Vengeance. Vengeance for Lazgar! We might not even need the Lazgar's Vengeance to win this game, actually. We're just gonna go, like, beep beep into Blamsmith's Scrounge. Like, make this bigger, make some Dreadlings. Despite all the rage, still just a rat in a cage, like... Beep beep. I don't know if he's DOB, but he's definitely dead to the cards in our hand. Look at him slide all the way down. And now, like, my opponent tanks here to, like figure out optimal blocks and figure out exactly what's going on. I'm just gonna let them know in chat that I have 2x lives. I really wish, this is the one downside to a digital game over a paper game. If this was a game of Magic, like, my opponent has no cards in hand, I'd just, like, flip my hand over and be like, look, you're dead. It doesn't matter what your decisions are here. The game is over. Here, my opponent has to tank and figure out optimal blocks before I kill them with these 2 Lazgar's Vengeance. Alright, so batting 50% on the speculative 1 threshold keeps on the draw. Yeah, but, like, he'd also have to believe me that, like, they're free to play, too. Like, that doesn't guarantee that as well. I'm gonna go ahead and put, this is gonna be the end of the Redlings deck for today. I'm gonna go